have a merchant talk from one of our favorite clients, Wing Thai. From Wing Thai, we have Shailendra Singh, AVP Head of Engineering, Wing Thai Retail Group. And the topic of this talk is Wing Thai Retail E-commerce Journey.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. So I think since morning, I think almost everybody has talked about e-commerce, growth of e-commerce. So I think almost everybody agrees that there's a growth, there's a lot of future for the e-commerce. So I'm definitely not going to talk about that, okay, whether it's going to decline or it go exponential. I think for a merchant's point of view, we understand that there is a lot of market opportunity. How much as a merchant, how much you can grab, that's the only question. But the growth-wise, there's no doubt. So that's what I'm cover about some of our journey in last 2 years. So let me introduce a bit about what about me, and then we'll go about our journey in short. So I've been working at Wing Thai for over 2 years now, and yeah, prior to Wing Thai, I have been working with a lot of tech companies here in India, some of the startups, be in Yahoo, in Property Guru, and if you know about Simplistic, Rotimatic, which have so a variety of the tech industries before I started working for Wing Thai. A bit about the Wing Thai Wing Thai Retail and where we are part of. Wing Thai Retail is a part of the Wing Thai Holdings, which is bigger group and which is already listed in the Singapore Exchange. What Wing Thai Retail has works with a lot of international brands, to name a few: these G2000, Kazakhstan, Adidas, Furla, Surgeon Major, DPAM, and those. Prior to few months before, we were also carrying Topshop, Dorothy Perkins in this region before they got acquired by ASOS and Boohoo's from the UK. That's a bit about the company. So now let's talk about some of the digital or your total e-commerce journey for us. Of course, we were totally zero in 2019. Before, this is some of the digital transformation we were discussing before pandemic. But of course, pandemic happened, then some of the stuff we were benefited as a e-commerce, but some of the stuff did start early 2019. Of course, I think a lot of merchants can join, can think about this journey. They do have retail presence, or some of them, let's say, want to do they don't have a retail, but they just want to go to the online world. So what are the challenges they face? What are the decisions they need to make sure so that you have a successful or a profitable business for their companies? So for us, one of the starting point was what platforms, what tools, what technologies you should start. So of course it's a factor for us, because we operate variety of the brands, and at some stage you want individual presence for your brand, at some stage you want a something Zalora or those stuff where maybe you can provide all brands at one place. Then those are the decisions you need to make. So of course for us, we were a bigger brand, we were carrying 6 to 8 brands. We knew that maybe for us the roadmap, for a site or e-commerce perspective, we are bigger. That's why some of the decisions we had to take into consideration that, okay, so that at some stage after a few years, we should be able to transform each and every stuff. So those are the decisions we had to make. And since we started the whole e-commerce or the digital transformation stuff, the first thing, of course, is a very challenging one, because you need to make a lot of decisions, set the correct platform before your first project or goes the e-commerce or starts full-fledged e-commerce. That's what the same with us. I think maybe a lot of the retail, or maybe if somebody is planning today, of course you can understand that first will definitely take a longer time, and the moment you, of course, the future ones will be you'll be able to achieve in much faster time period. That was the same for us. The Kazakhstan site, it took roughly 8 to 9 months from idea to the see live traffic, live orders, and those stuff. And for subsequent, I'll cover what all the sites we launched for the till now, and of course, we were able to launch every site after 2 to 3 months afterwards because of the platform and because of the tech stack we chose. So yeah, for now, I'll cover about some of the challenges which basically we had to make at the start of it, and some of them are after we have launched, maybe these are a part of day-to-day business or day-to-day decisions we need to take from some of them. We need, yeah. So first of all, it's definitely the faster transformation. If you have a retail presence or if you want to go digital, of course it takes time. Of course, as maybe the organization or maybe everybody wants a faster way, but it does take some time. So that's definitely a challenge it took for us also, because we wanted to set the correct platform, correct process, so that the future is better. That's why so this is the first challenge. It's kind of understandable, but I think just to make other people understand, come to the same page, it does take some time. The second challenges we faced was the digitalization process. So assume like you have a retail shop running, but you want to bring each and every catalog to the e-commerce. You can also understand maybe some platform like Magento or Shopify, building a front-end site is still maybe 15-20 days effort, but more effort goes around how to make sure that you have the correct catalog, how do you have the media, images, and everything is perfect. Catalog wise, you have each and every information you have, so that whatever you want to show on your site. That is a much, much bigger effort than maybe creating a front-end site or front-end store. Third option is around payment integration. Of course, I think you guys had, I think there were a lot of sessions from morning, and even as of now in Singapore, you will find that maybe more than 10 payment options available. But they have challenges. There are sometimes technical challenges in integration, and sometimes there are more around when you have a lot of volumes, every penny counts. So as a business, sometimes, okay, they want to save some single cent, so that for a longer term, you are benefited. So a lot of effort goes around the decision day to day. Of course, it's not required on day one, but over a period of time, if you want for let's talk few years, those decisions have to be from time to time. You need to evaluate whether this payment solution is correct or if we need to move to another one. Some of the other decisions around the buy now and use later, pay later. So of course, for integration, why this may be a simpler integration, but sometimes you never know that maybe for one country will perform much, much better on the pay later solution. And so those are the decisions you cannot understand later, but once you launch one line, then you look at the data, you find that, okay, maybe a country like Malaysia has much, much conversion around the pay later schemes rather than maybe some of the other countries. The fourth challenge is more around the warehouse and 3PL integrations. Of course, if you are a small merchant, you don't have each and everything, the capabilities, what are the other warehouse solutions available, how do you make sure the item gets delivered. So there are a lot of solutions available in Singapore and for Malaysia. So those integrations, of course, that also does take some time, but that's also very much required as part of your whole e-commerce experience. And the last one, definitely some of the, I think the PAN people did discuss about the omni-channel integration. They discuss about the numbers, they did that, definitely this is the future. But yes, once you start integrating, then you'll find that there are some challenges involved in kind of making sure that you are able to provide the omni-channel experience on your e-commerce site. So that you buy e-commerce, return on the store, or the vice versa and those stuff. There are a lot of real day-to-day challenges involved if you really want to implement the omni-channel stuff. So these are the challenges faced by us maybe in almost last 2 years. After resolving some of the challenges, as of now, we are because we chose Magento as our platform, we are able to launch these 5 sites. As well, on the top of it, we had 4 e-commerce sites, Topshop and Dorothy Perkins in 2 regions, which we just shut down a few months before. So so roughly, I can say around 9 e-commerce sites I'll say less than 2 years. So, and of course, I think expecting the business from zero value to decent, significant, I'll say around, business is growing. So that's decent effort from, I'll say, journey-wise. And this is the last, the site we launched sometime the 2 weeks back, pre-Diwali, and which offers the child, a solution for kids in both Singapore and Malaysia. So the next one is more around what next. So of course, launching is first part, making sure that e-commerce is available. But of course, as I said, there are a lot of opportunity. It's up to you how much you want to, what you do so that the larger, you are able to capture the larger chunk out of the opportunities available. So of course, as I said, we have just launched, but we don't have a lot of features. Some of the omnichannel experience we still have to do. Some of the payment solutions we still have a very limited. Maybe we want to differently wallets and those stuff we want to launch. Of course, some more partnership to bring more business. Some of we also have planned for a few more e-commerce sites. And also to bring whatever the Llama Lolly we mentioned, we are working with a few more brands so that our kids site has more offerings. We can compete with maybe Zalora for kids and those sections. I think, with that, thank you. I think any questions from the audience or from the online? That's it, guys. Thank you.